Hello everyone, myself Professor Sandeep Abhang, lecturer in Mechanical Engineering Department, CSMSS College of Polytechnic, Aurangabad. Today we are going to learn design procedure of knuckle joint. In last lecture we have seen what is knuckle joint and their applications. The two rods are tightened together by means of a knuckle joint and load P is acting on both the rod axially, so that the parameters are considered like this. Let P is a tensile load acting on a rod, D is a diameter of shaft or rod, D1 is the diameter of knuckle pin, D2 outside diameter of eye, then D3 diameter of knuckle pin head or collar, T small t is a thickness of single eye, this is T thickness of single eye, T1 is the thickness of fork, T2 thickness of pin head or collar. So come to the next point. The first step of design procedure is failure of rod in tension. So consider a rod diameter d, small d. So the area will becomes pi by 4 d square. So the tensile stress is given by sigma t is equal to p by pi by 4 d square. Give the equation number 1, and from this equation we can calculate or we have obtained diameter of rod d. The second step is, or the second procedure is, failure of knuckle pin in shear. So that in second step we are finding out in two ways. First of all, failure of knuckle pin is in double shear. So consider the knuckle pin is under the double shear. So due to double shear, the D1 is the diameter of knuckle pin due to double shear multiply by 2. So it will becomes 2 into pi by 4 D1 square, and the equation becomes tau equal to P by 2 into pi by 4 D1 square. So from this equation we can calculate the diameter of knuckle pin, and step second B, in this step we can fix the dimensions by using empirical relations. So first is the diameter of pin, which is equal to diameter of rod D. Outer diameter of an eye is equal to D2, which is equal to 2 times of diameter of rod. Third, diameter of knuckle pin head or collar, D3, equal to 1.5 times of diameter of rod. Thickness of single eye, small t, is equal to 1.25 times of diameter of rod. Thickness of fork, T1, is equal to 1.75 times of D, and thickness of knuckle pin head or collar is equal to. So the third step is checking the failure of single eye in tension across the slot. See here, it is the diagram of single eye, and across this slot the failure will be occur. The parameters are D1 is the diameter of or internal diameter of the single eye, and D2 is the outer diameter of the single eye, and T is the thickness. See the diagram where whenever we are applying load on this rod and again opposite side to the another rod, so it will fail like this, isn't it? So the area of failure becomes in the tension is like this. See, This is the portion. In this portion, the failure will be occur. The total area or total length of this D2, consider it is as a length, not a diameter, and D1 is the internal diameter or internal distance, and T is the thickness of single eye. So the area resisting tearing of single eye will becomes D2 minus D1 into T. So then the tensile stress is given by, we know that stress is equal to load upon area of cross section or force upon area, so that sigma T is equal to P upon area. Area is nothing but the D2 minus D1 into T. Give the equation number 3. Then step 4, similarly checking the failure of single eye in or for crushing stress. It means that same diagram or read the same diagram for the checking crushing stress. In this step, checking the safe crushing, the induced crushing stress should not exceed the permissible induced crushing stress. We have to check out in this step, so that where the crushing stress is induced, where whenever we are inserting the knuckle pin into the or through the single eye hole, and in that area which is contacted from this end, we are applying the load, so that at this portion, understand, at this portion it is touches to the surface of this internal portion, so it is in contact with the surface of internal surface of the single eye. So due to that, there is no relative motion between them, hence the crushing stress will be developed. So that at this area, means we have to subtract D1 area from D2, we will get the area for crushing. So what will be the area? The area resisting crushing single eye is equal to T. T is nothing but the thickness of single eye, consider as a height, and D, D as a distance. So the induced crushing stress is equal to or is given by sigma CK equal to P upon T into D1. Give the equation number 4. In next step, step 5th, checking the failure of single eye in shear stress. Similarly, we have to check one by one, first of all in tension, second in checking in crushing, and third in shear. So for shear stress, consider this diagram or see or refer this diagram. See here, whenever we are applying the load from this end and also from in the fork from this end, so the contacted area to the pin will be shear off or break out like this. We are considering only the failure will be occurred like this. So the, what are the parameters? Consider it is the center of an eye or it is a diameter. Okay, so from the center, what will be the distance? D1 by 2 and D2 by 2. This internal distance become D1 by 2 and the external distance become D2 by 2, and T is the thickness of a single eye. So add this D2 minus D1 divided by 2. So consider the area resisting crushing of single shearing for single eye. What will be the area? D2, it is the total. D1, consider in this area the shear stress will be developed, and T is the thickness. So area will be, see here, area equal to 2 into D2 minus D1 divided by 2 as it is. Why 2? Because there are two surfaces in contact. This is the first surface and this is the second surface. This surface with this surface, it is a first shearing, and this surface with this surface is the second shearing. So multiply by 2 because it is in double shear, and remaining d2 minus d1, these are the distances, divided by 2 because it is a half distance from the center, into t. T is the thickness of a single eye. So equation becomes 2 get cancelled, d2 minus d1 into t. This is the area under shearing. Then the shear stress is given by tau is equal to p upon or p divided by d2 minus d1 into t. Give the name equation 5. In the next step, step 6, checking the failure of fork end in tension across the slot. Similarly, we are seeing in the single eye, first of all in tension, second in crushing, and third in shear. One by one we have to consider like this, first of all in tension, second in crushing, and third in shear. So refer this diagram for this consideration. See, it is a fork which has two ends, upper end and lower end, called as a upper end and lower end. So t1 is the thickness of fork end, d1 is also diameter, internal diameter of fork, and d2 is the outer diameter of fork, similarly single eye. So the area resisting tearing for the fork end or double eye across the slot is, what will be the area? Area will be, see, like this. This area for upper fiber or upper end or lower end, at this stage the failure will be occur whenever we are applying the tensile load. The green area shows the failure area for the tensile. So hole d2 minus d1 into thickness t1, the area will be how much fork end is there, 2 fork, upper and lower, so multiply by 2 into d2 minus d1, which is area. We have to subtract unconsiderable area from the considered area, d2 minus d1 into t1. T1 is the thickness of fork. Then the tensile stress is given by sigma t equal to p upon 2 into d2 minus d1 into t1. So from this we are checking how much of tensile stress is developed in the fork end. Next, step 7, checking the failure of fork end in crushing. So similarly, like a single eye, also we are checking for fork end. So for fork end, similarly refer previous diagram as shown in figure. So checking the safe crushing, induced crushing stress should not exceed the permissible limit. So area resisting crushing for fork end, similarly in last tension we are considering this area for the tensile failure, but in this area this portion is considerable because whenever knuckle pin is contacted with this internal portion of the fork, then the crushing stress will be developed at this area. So due to this, because there is no relative motion between them, the crushing stress will be developed at this portion. So consider this portion, d2 is the total portion, subtract the d1 is the considerable portion for the crushing area or crushing stress developed area, and the t1 is the thickness of fork end. So the area will become 2 into, why multiply by 2? Because upper end and lower end, multiply by 2 into d1 into t1. So then the induced crushing stress will be sigma ck equal to load or p upon 2 into d1 into t1. Next step, step 8. In 8th step we are checking the failure of fork end in shearing. So again consider this similar diagram for shearing also, as like a single. So consider again this diagram. Again D1 is the considerable area and D2 is the unconsiderable area. So subtract D1 from D2 for crushing stress, sorry, shearing stress, but due to two ends multiply by 2, so it is in double shear, into D2 minus D1 into T1, then the induced crushing stress is tau equal to P upon 2 into D2 minus D1 into T1. Give the equation number 8. Ninth step. In ninth step, checking the failure of knuckle pin in shearing. Already we have seen that in second step, it is in double shear, or the pin is in double shear. Consider double shearing of a pin like this. See the diagram. The one end of the pin or two end of the pin is in fork and one end is in the single eye. So like this, the failure of the knuckle pin is will be like this. D1 is the diameter of the knuckle pin and the failure is like this. So consider the pin is in double shear as shown in figure, where D1 is the diameter of knuckle pin. So the area resisting shearing will be 2 into Y2 because of 2 double shear, where double shear at this surface and this surface and this surface and this surface, it is in double shear, so that multiply by 2 into pi by 4 D1 square. Here then the induced shear stress will be tau equal to P by 2 into pi by 4 D1 square. Give the equation number 9. Here we can check whether induced shear stress is less than permissible value or not. Thank you very much for watching my video.